I'm going to show you how to hack an old supplement for strength, power, speed using my NASA research, and we are getting started right now. What is going on? My name is David Barr. If you're looking to get bigger, faster, stronger, get leaner, go longer, hit that subscribe and then the little bell so you don't miss the latest tips, tricks, and things you need to fix. Speaking of fixing, there's three things you need to know about this supplement, things we need to revisit so we can really use it. Tap into our strength, power, speed, because right now it's a bodybuilding supplement and it's not even really great for that. But based on newer research and based on some of my NASA research experience, I think there's a way we can hack this to really tap into our neurochemistry. And that is the fundamental component of this series. My goal is to gently introduce neurochemistry, neuroscience, nice, easy, applied way to really tap into that strength, power, speed that we're missing out on. Because right now we're in the dark ages and we need to get out of that. We need to advance the conversation and the field. And at the end, stay tuned for the three tips you need to take full advantage of this information. So this one kicked off working for NASA at the Johnson Space Center, looking at countermeasures for muscle wasting in spaceflight, trying to get Elon Musk to Mars and that kind of thing. And one of the things we were looking at was the conversion of fiber types. And we actually did not want to see a conversion to a faster fiber type, because that meant that the muscle was wasting. In space, our default fiber type is going to be the fastest fiber type. It's only when we're in gravity, when we're loading, we're fatiguing, that makes us slower. And it doesn't make a lot of sense at first, but then you realize key adaptation is to mitigate fatigue. So if there's no stress on the muscle, we're going to have a faster fiber type. This is important for you because what it means is that the signals that we need for strength, power, speed, they are minor signals, they are secondary signals. And when we get more powerful fatigue signals, like hydrogen ions, acid, even at a very small level, it's going to override those secondary characteristics that we want, those secondary signals. So we have to eliminate those more powerful signals as much as we can. So consider that you train with lower reps and longer rest periods to eliminate those signals. It's not just about the signals you're providing, it's about the signals that you're eliminating. So if we really want to maximize that strength, power, speed, we need to eliminate the fatigue signal as much as possible. And there's research out of Poland showing that there's a neurotransmitter that could be advantageous for this. Second key is working through a neurotransmitter called GABA. We don't want this one, it shuts us down. Neurotransmitters can get very complicated. We don't need the details right now, but it is important to know, we'll just summarize, GABA is a shut down neurotransmitter. It's not great for learning. It's probably not great for strength, speed, that kind of thing. So we want to eliminate it as much as possible without dipping into pathophysiology. We want to have normal but low levels. And there is a common supplement that could mitigate the potential effects of this GABA. I talked about this on my second ever Muscle and Fitness article back in the day. We're talking centuries ago, but the theory still holds. The supplement that we typically use for fellow meatheads for bodybuilding, again, doesn't really work that well for it. I show how to fix it in another video, but there is a hack that we can use and it could potentially mitigate the effect of GABA. If you're thinking about going the more hardcore route of pharmaceutical blockage of GABA antagonists, we don't want that. They're potentially dangerous. They could cause seizures. It's something we don't want to mess with. That's why we're talking about extrapolated theory and supplements, trying to keep this as safe, but as potent as possible. We have to consider the potential SYNGENIC effect, which is a novel emergent synergistic effect when using this supplement with others. That is why you need to check out the other videos in this series to tap into your neurotransmitters and make sure you're optimizing your strength, power, speed. Again, we are in the dark ages. This series is designed to get us out of that. Now the third key, this is the big one. This is what you're after. It's the actual supplement and you've heard of it, you've probably used it, but there's a trick to it. We have to use it in a certain way to actually work for us. I talked about this in another video where we're just expecting to take a supplement and, you know, expect it to do all the work. We have to work with the supplement. If we're not working along the same mechanism of action as the supplement, it's not going to do anything. So there's a hack to this, so stay tuned for that. So this key supplement, this key ingredient, common amino acid, beta-alanine. Now again, I know you've heard of this, probably haven't heard it discussed in this way before, because we're talking about GABA antagonism, blocking GABA or potentially some of its effects. And we're also talking about mopping up those hydrogen ions, that acid, that even a little bit could cause a shift to a slower type of muscle. Now, of course, this is extrapolated theory, but still there is research behind this. So the keys to using this are A, use it when you're protein fasted. That will ensure maximum transport through the gut, through the blood, into muscle. Secondly, I use this about 45 minutes before a lift, trying to make sure that the blood levels are high, getting across the CNS, a blood-brain barrier, trying to get to the CNS, get to the brain where it can do its magic. And lastly, dosing. If you haven't used this before, you might experience some of that paresthesia, the tingling. Some people love it, some people don't. But if you're brand new to it, I would start off with a lower dose, say 2 grams, work your way up. I think to be maximally effective, you're going to need more, probably 4 or 5 grams at a single dose. Because again, we are not using it just to load our muscle up. We are using it as an antagonist for GABA. We're using it to mop up those hydrogen ions, and that's going to be more of an acute effect. So here are your 3 next steps that you can use to take full advantage of this information. Number 1, consider the concept of signals. This is a paradigm shift. We need to rethink how we're looking at signals. It's not just the signals that we're providing, it's also the signals that we're eliminating. In this case, it's going to be the hydrogen ions, eliminating as much as possible because they are a master regulator. They are a very, very powerful signal that we want to get rid of. Secondly, consider using beta-alanine. This one's pretty simple, right? I don't make any recommendations, prescriptions. Doesn't matter what the certifications are behind this. Legally, this is just a CYA thing. So just consider using beta-alanine in this way and why we're using it in this way. Lastly, check out the other videos in this series. Again, we're talking SYNGENIC effect. This entire series is built around optimizing our neurochemistry, optimizing our neurotransmitters. It sounds big and scary, and that's probably why we haven't touched it, but there's a ton of info out there that we need to use, apply to advance the conversation, advance the field, and your strength, power, speed. So there's your 3 next steps. You have your marching orders. This is the best supplements for Olympic weightlifting and powerlifting series. Thanks for watching. I'm David Barr, and until next time, raise the bar.